Good morning. We're glad you have joined us today. We're going to start off our morning by singing, Did You Ever Talk to God? And I hope you've talked to God this morning. So we're going to sing, Did You Ever Talk to God? And if you haven't, you can right now. Sing with me. I want to hear you singing right where you are. You sing even though I'm not there. Go ahead. Answer. God's word will give you direction when you don't know which way to go. We're now going to sing, We Were Made to Love the Lord. Okay, I hope you like this song this morning. The birds are singing, spring is here. Let's go ahead, let's sing. You and so do we, and God made us to serve Him. For these last few weeks, we have been talking about the Ten Commandments. So we're going to go through these right now. On the top, I don't know if the video can pick this up, but number one says, Thou shalt have no other gods before me. The second day, Thou shalt not worship any graven image. The third one, Thou shalt not take the name of the Lord thy God in vain. And last Sunday was, remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. And today we're going to learn about honor thy father and thy mother. And for those of you that have this sheet, okay, we pass these out, and if you want one, you can contact us online and we'll mail you one. If you're watching from a distance away, the word for today, for number five that you need to write on your paper, is honor. Okay, go get your paper right now and write down honor. We are to honor our father and our mother. What does that mean, to honor your father and mother? Well, to honor means to prize highly. I'm sure you have a special toy, or you have some special item that you prize highly. Well, that's the same thing with our mom and our dad. We should prize them very highly. God has given them to us, and we are to show them honor and respect. Excuse me. We are to treat them as precious or valuable. Why are your parents so valuable to you? They are God's gift to you. God has given you a gift in your parents. Think of all that they do and have done for you. They protect you from many dangers. They provide things that you need, like food and clothing. They even give you things you do not need, like toys and bikes and special treats. You can honor them by obeying. And I hope this morning, boys and girls, that you obey your mom and dad, because that's what God wants us to do. Be kind to your parents by speaking nicely when they ask you to do something. Show them respect. And maybe there are some children who have substitute parents, maybe grandparents, aunts and uncles. God wants you to honor them too. Even if you don't live with your parents all the time, honor them in every way that you can. People who honor their parents are people who please God and receive His promise as a blessing. So one more time, our special word for this morning, for this sheet of paper on number 5, is honor. We are to honor our father and our mother. Now, just for a review, if you can give this back to me, or you can email it or text it or whatever you need to do, you will get a prize if you have all of these blanks filled in. Okay? So number 3, you are to fill in name. For number 4, Sabbath. And for today, it's honor. And every Sunday for the next 5 weeks, we will learn another commandment. Okay, so remember, today we are to honor our father and our mother. So now we're going to sing our commandment song. Go ahead. Sing it with me.
This is my commandment, that you love one another, that your joy may be full. This is my commandment, that you love one another, that your joy may be full. That your joy may be full. That your joy may be full. This is my commandment, that you love one another, that your joy.
This morning, we're going to learn about someone who honored her mother-in-law. This wasn't even her mother, it was her mother-in-law. And we're going to learn how God blessed this person in a special way. It had not rained for a long, long time in the land of Judah. The crops were dead, the grass and the trees were dying. There was no food for the people to eat because the famine had spread throughout the land. We must go to Moab, said Elimelech to his wife Naomi. I hear that everything is green there, and we will have enough food to eat. If we stay here, we will starve to death. So Elimelech and Naomi, with their two sons, Mahlon and Chilion, left for the land of Moab. Upon their arrival, they had enough food to eat and were happy. But the new country was not like the land of Judah that they had left. In this new country, people worshipped idols. They worshipped an idol named Chemosh. He was called the God of Fire. He was made of brass, and in his outstretched hands, people burned sacrifices. But Naomi and her husband continued to worship the God, the true God, the Jehovah, and they taught their boys to worship him too. And then a very sad thing happened. Naomi's husband died, and she was left with her two sons. Later, the sons married Moabite girls, Orpah and Ruth. And the next 10 years were happy years. Instead of teaching her husband about the false God, Ruth learned to love the true God. But then another sad thing happened to this family. Both of Naomi's sons died. Now what was Naomi to do? Life was difficult for widows. And she missed people she left behind. People who loved the God that she loved. I hear that the famine is over in Bethlehem, Naomi said to Orpah and Ruth. God has blessed his people with good crops once again. It's time for me to go back home. Orpah and Ruth both cried when they heard Naomi was leaving. We want to go with you, said her daughters-in-law. Naomi agreed they could go with her. But after they began their journey, she changed her mind. She said to Orpah and Ruth, and hear that. Go back, my daughters. Return to your parents' home. Then Orpah kissed her mother-in-law and said goodbye and started back to her gods and to her home. So she left. She went back home to her parents. But Ruth said, I don't make me leave you, for I want to go wherever you go and live wherever you live. Your people shall be my people, and your God shall be my God. Naomi could see that Ruth had made up her mind. So Naomi and Ruth once again lived together, and they kept walking until they came to the village of Bethlehem. This is where I have family, said Naomi. We will stop here. So much had happened since Naomi had left her country. She was probably very sad and happy at the same time to be home. It was good to see the purple grapes and the fields of golden corn, and she was glad to see her friends. But her friends noticed that Naomi didn't look like she used to when she left. Her eyes were sad, and her face was wrinkled. Is it really you? The women asked. She said, don't call me Naomi. Call me Mara. Naomi means pleasant, but Mara means bitter. For much sadness had come into Naomi's life. I want to change my name because now I am sad and not happy like I was when I once lived here. Her neighbors and her friends probably prayed, please God, make Naomi happy. Naomi showed a spirit of selflessness when she asked her daughter-in-laws to return home. But God honored her spirit and blessed her by having Ruth remain with her. And because Ruth honored Naomi, God made her the great-great-grandmother of Boaz, who was the descendant of King David, through whom came Jesus, our Savior. God blessed Ruth because she honored her mother-in-law. And what about you? Are you honoring your parents or whoever is your substitute parents this morning? I hope you are. And if you're not, you can start right now. Why don't you start by asking mom or dad or whoever is there with you if you could help with the dishes? I'm sure they'd be very surprised and they'd be very happy if you did. We are going to go to do you have a question? That's a tape. So if you have a question in your life, who do we go to? We go to God and he will answer. Okay, let's sing. Now remember, the boys are gonna sing separate.
Do you have a question? Go to God in prayer. Do you have a problem? He's the one who cares. Do you have a burden? He alone will share. Are you tired and lonely? Jesus will be there.
Okay, boys, you sing the question. Girls, you sing the answer. Here we go.
Boys.
Do you have a question? Go to God in prayer.
Boys.
Do you have a problem? He's the one who cares.
Do you have a burden?
He alone will share.
Are you tired and lonely?
question. Boys, you give us the answers.
Do you have a question?
I think some of the boys forgot to sing this morning. Okay, we're going to do one more song. It's changing little by little and day by day. What? And boys and girls, remember, right where you are, I want to hear you sing it. So we're going to start off with our prayer song, okay? I want you to fold your hands and close your eyes because we're talking to Jesus. And when we're done singing, then we'll pray. The blessings that you have bestowed upon us, even though we're in the midst of a trying time. Lord, you have blessed us and you have been with us, and we thank you for it. We thank you, Lord, for these Ten Commandments that you have given to us. We thank you this morning that you love us and that you are there for us when we need you. We ask that you'd help the children this morning. As we learned that we should honor our father and our mother, be with each one. Help them, Lord, to honor their parents in a very special way today. And for all that you have done for us, we thank you and we praise you. Amen. And we thank you for joining us today. Join us next week. Hope you have a wonderful day. God bless.